How's everyone doing today?
Doing great with that weed news.
Yeah. Well, it's March and weed's gonna kick off here.
Right?
So, yep. We know the pattern, right? We should at least.
Yeah, when Inbar tweeted out those that list, it was like just confirmation for me. It's like, oh, I loaded in the right time finally.
Yep. I saw the news and I was like, I wonder if he knows about this. So, and then in pre-market, it shot up to like 12%. I'm like, yay. It looks like all the meme stocks are going up again. So, which
Yeah,
is
what's up
like,
with the meme? Is it... Or should we just wait?
You say,
I'm
what's
not
up
really
with the
sure.
memes? Well, they're memes, so like they just go up just because that's what a meme
Right.
is.
They're getting
Right.
pumped. Yeah. So,
Okay, I didn't know.
all the Fed, like, okay, so there's a lot of things happening. It looks like smart money is trying to pull out. This market's gonna be a little different than what we're used to. I spoke to some experts in the stock market, and we're gonna see a lot of things. Do you want to go ahead and start the recording thingy?
It started. You guys just have a flowing conversation. Hey, everybody, welcome to RST Best Practices. Just a disclaimer, this is for entertainment purposes only. This is not, we don't know what we're talking about. Don't buy our tickers, don't sell our tickers, don't do anything because we said to do it. It's for your entertainment.
Yeah, we're do your own diligence.
DD, do it yourself.
Yep. All right. So welcome everyone to our Tuesday best practice training that we do every weekly here at RST. Hopefully you guys had a great week. We will do a recap to see how everyone's week's been going from last week. But yeah, to go back to what I was saying was that it looks like there's a lot of smart money, like bankers and stuff. So, did you guys watch Spy today? Anyone?
I glanced at it.
I worked, but I watched it for the power hour.
Yeah, I
Did you see
glanced
how
at it.
crazy it went?
Yeah.
Okay. So, they're pumping it. They're pumping the markets. They're putting money into it. So, what's going to happen is we're not going to have money to put into the markets anymore. These hedges and the liquidity is going to dry up. So what they're doing now is they're pumping the market to get smart money out and get retail to buy them up. So just be very careful when you do your investments, moving forward. Don't go in there trying to win home runs. Be very careful how you invest, and how you trade. Okay. So, the federal hike again is going to happen in May. So right now we're at 0.25. I think by May we'll be at 0.05. I think you guys heard Jay Powell speak. He kind of scared everyone. Was it today or yesterday? I'm not sure. I don't remember. But so just pay attention, pay attention to what's happening, watch the news. There's a lot of stuff going on with the war still, and so there's a lot of things happening. There's a lot of moving parts, so keep that in mind. Hi, Ms. Raquel, it's good to see you on here. We miss you.
Hello, missed you guys too. Hope everyone's doing well.
Yes. Did you have a good vacation in Aruba?
Amazing.
Yay. That's awesome. Okay, so stocks only, how's your week been going?
I have had a great week. Last week was great. My first 2 days were sideways. My last 3 days were green. And this week I'm green. So
Good.
happy about it.
Yes. Yes, I feel like, since we've been doing these trainings and we talked to each other, I've been really blessed because I've been paying more attention to a lot of little things that I was missing. And just like, being in these trainings and learning from all these other guys. We've had some great calls in RST. Inbar has really been killing it lately. So if you guys have been in any of his tickers, you would know that you should be up. You should be making money. I mean, he's really great.
If you catch anything in bar calls, you should be making money.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, fire.
Because he's from the year 2050.
Yeah, he's awesome. Do you want to go ahead and start the first video?
Yeah, let me swap the screen so it can be heard audio wise. All right, here's our first video.
As real as I can put it, jealousy is real and loyalty is rare. It's crazy how you can be there for everybody, but when you need somebody, nobody seems to be there. You know, fake people don't surprise me anymore. Loyal people do. It's like, no matter how much you were there for their struggle, when you go through yours, don't be surprised when they forget about you. But that's life. No matter how good you are to them, doesn't mean they're gonna treat you the same. Just because they mean that much to you, doesn't mean they're gonna value you the same. It's always the ones that said they would never change. They end up being the main ones that change. They go from being real to acting strange. They go from giving support to giving pain. It's insane how you can do so much for a person and yet they still feel comfortable talking down on your name. Like you wasn't the one that helped them get it right. Like you was the one that sacrificed so much for their life. But people tend to forget about the favors when they become haters. And just like that, they'll switch up on you overnight. They'll go from talking to you to talking about you. They'll try to throw dirt on your name to stain your character. So before a stranger even gets to know you, they already start to doubt you straight up. With no hesitation, they'll try to ruin your reputation by creating false accusations just to benefit their situation. As you can see, sometimes it's the ones you cut for that turn out to be cutthroat. And sometimes it's the ones you think you see eye to eye with turn out to be the ones you gotta watch the most. Trust me. Just because they close, they can still be far for real. And it's sad when it's the same ones that you would give your life for money, for fame, for any gain, they'll set you up to have you killed for real. So understand, when loyalty isn't returned, that bridge has to be burned. Don't let it take someone showing you multiple times that loyalty is not their top priority for you to finally learn. So if you always gotta question their loyalty, then maybe it's time for that chapter to be closed. And never forget this fact about life. Someone's loyalty is just something that you can't control.
Oh my gosh, I love that last part. It was like, just burn them.
That was a good video. It's true too. It's all true.
It's absolutely true. So, you know, if you have people in your life that are just going to be naysayers, haters, you know, they're not loyal to you, they don't, you know, believe in you, yada yada, you know, you trusted them and they backstabbed you. Seriously, guys, we don't need that in our lives, and just let them go. Burn a sage, do whatever, and set them off into the world. You know, make sure that your tribe is people that you want to be around, that want to help you, that help you grow, that inspire you, motivate you, that push you to your limits. You know, they do give you constructive criticism, but at the same time, you know that they love you and that's why they're doing it, and they support you. You know, those are the types of people that you want to be around. And In our trading journey, you know, we make friends, and sometimes our friends become our enemies for whatever reason. You know, we might have been in the same stock together and it didn't work out for them, but, you know, and then they have resentment, hatefulness, whatever. So, you know, stuff happens, but at the end of the day, you know, we just have to be true to ourselves and keep it moving. But if there's people in your life that are constantly bringing you down, talking negatively, you know, they throw shade, do all those little jabs here and there. Seriously, it's a waste of time to deal with that. It's a waste of time to acknowledge it. Just move on.
Yeah, I can confirm that. I've had plenty of people, not just in the stock world, but plenty of people in my life that, just like the video said, I value much more than they value me, and I didn't know that until they proved it to me, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Sucks to be on that end of shit, but at least I'm the one that's loyal, you know?
Exactly. Just be loyal to yourself, be loyal to God, and be loyal to your family and friends that mean the most to you. And, you know, and you're going to help people. And I've noticed that you're going to help people in this life and they're going to backstab you. I've been through it in the last 2 years in the stock journey. So, you know, people I've never met in my life, like face to face, but they have done it. And I, you know, usually I've never been through anything like this, the stock journey, especially being invested in LTNC and stuff. But let me tell you, it's been an eye opener. Money, you know, comes and goes, but the way you make people feel will stay forever, you know? So that's that. All right. So let's talk about stocks. How was y'all's week? What are your wins? I'm telling you, I'm having an amazing week. I had an amazing week last week. I'm having another amazing week this week. Stocks are just, these stocks are doing well, the ones that I'm playing, and they're running off the news and the trends. Most of these ones are like low float, so they go real quickly, and I just take profit.
Yeah, I've been taking profit.
Yeah.
And I have been really strict on ourselves. We sit there and talk back and forth, like, should we, where, like, okay, well, this is where it could go, but look at this move. Like, fuck it, we're out. Let's get out. Like, if it's green, we sell it.
Yeah.
That's what I've been...
5% here, 7% there, 12%, whatever, take your profits. Because that stock's going to drop again, and then you can get back in.
This one here, and Archon, made money on this today.
Nice.
We had it at 109, and then it dropped down yesterday and shot up after hours. We expected a move, and we sold right here at the very top of this move, because we're like, oh, shoot, should we get out? Yeah, let's get out. And then look, I mean, it's still up there, but so what? We're out. We have a core at 109, a small little bit. In case we see a big dip in the morning, I'll buy some more. See if I can, you know, make some more money on it. Have a tight stop, whatever.
Well, if it goes up, you can always buy.
Right, exactly. You can just buy the strength. If it goes up and finds a new floor, just buy the floor. Buy the new floor.
Yeah.
You know. But that's, you know, and it's little gains. And I have a small account, and I don't care. If it's green, it's green. I want to end every day green. I want to never see a red day. And I know that's not, you know, I'm going to see a red day at times, but my goal is to never have a red day. If something's running and I'm like, well, I expected a $2 move, but this is a 50 cent move and it's stopping, I'm fucking selling it. You know, I'm taking my money, getting out. The market has proven to me that it doesn't give a shit. So I'm taking my money when it's there. You know?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
That was my only win the day as far as what I sold, you know, lock profits in Archon.
I sold CYRN yesterday.
Some CERN.
Too early. But yeah, CERN was...
That one's a big watch for tomorrow, guys. It's got that INDO kind of vibes going on. And me and Jen have been in and out of it for the last week and a half. That stock... it's a trending stock. It's a fundamental stock right now because of what's happening with Russia cyber attacking. The company is actually here local to me. They're in McLean, Virginia. So instead of me just trading the stock, I decided to do a little DD on them. They serve 1.5 billion customers around the world. And securing their data and security and cybersecurity stuff. So it's a pretty good stock. The high of that stock was like, I think, $19. That was the 52-week high. It's a low float. I think the float's like 7 million.
CERN?
How much?
2.5 million.
That's the free float?
Yeah, that's what it says right here.
Oh, even great. Even yep. better.
So, average volume. Average volume is higher than the float. You know it's going. It's going to go. That's crazy.
Well, you got the INDO vibe. I'm not saying that it's going to go to $50 or $100.
I think you're covering your microphone. Your
oh, sorry.
There you go.
Can you guys hear me? Okay, I'm not saying that it's going to go to $50, $80, or $100. But what I'm saying is it's got a lot of fundamentals to it. They have ER due on Thursday. After hours, and they're projected to have a good ER. So,
careful. But play it.
Yeah, they're projected to have a good ER. Looks like, but we're not sure. I mean, obviously, we don't know what their ER is going to be, but everyone's saying it's going to be good. So, whatever. But it's trending right now, and the reason it's trending is because Russia has, cyber attacks. They're talking about cyber attacks. They hacked our freaking Instagram, our White House official Instagram page. If you go to the White House Instagram page, the official account, if you check on any of those comments, they're all in Russian. So click on any of the posts and then look at the comments. It's all Russian. So that happened last Friday, I believe, or Thursday. And then now the president has been briefed by NSA, which is the National Security Agency, and intelligence, that they're trying to cyber attack Fortune 500 companies here in the United States. So
energy.
Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of stuff going on. So that stock it's trending. It's got the low float. It's got a borrow rate of 360%. So the short's really like it's a really expensive stock to short. So, it's on an upward trend. I think yesterday it went from $6 to $10.
Yeah.
$10.25.
$5.85 to $10.26.
Today it went from $7 to not almost $10 today, and it closed the market today at $7.80. So it's on an upward trend. So pay attention to it. I'm in it. I have a lot of shares in it, so I'm hoping for the best, and we'll see what happens. But it's a high watch for tomorrow morning.
Okay.
Pre-market.
I have, what did I buy today? SDPI, I think.
Hello, everybody.
Hi.
I bought SDPI Superior Drilling because it was $1.06 or $1.07 or something like that. And it's oil and it hasn't really had a big run in the last few days. You know what I mean?
What's the float on it?
12 million.
Okay. That's not bad.
Yeah. So.
It looks like it's at the bottom.
I think, I don't know who mentioned it. Somebody mentioned it in RST, I think. Maybe it was Alpha, because he was talking about ENSV, and he said there was other good oil stocks that haven't run yet, and I started to look for them, and someone mentioned one, and I looked at this one, and I liked the price and the chart, so I bought some today. But I forget who actually mentioned it. But this is oil, and it's only $1.10, and it doesn't have any crazy volatile moves besides, here on the 8th. Earlier this month, but just a thought.
Yeah, put that in the room. I'll put it to my watch list.
Yeah, for me, I'm still in MULN, so I sold at $4, like most of my position. And then I bought back in at 304. And now we're like at 337-ish or something like that.
339.
Good job. Yes, I mean, I'm having a good time with this stock. It has been performing very well. And well,
is that a stock you're trading? Are you just no, trading through? No.
Well, I'm still in HYMC. So I kept lowering my average. So it was to begin with, it was 260. Now I got it down to 204.
Oh, 260.
Yeah.
You were on the chase.
So, let's see what happened. I got a call from my boss, and I completely lost sight of what I was doing with this stock.
Well, HYMC had a nice little move today.
Yeah. So, I mean, it had a nice little move. I mean, I'll break even at 204.
Damn,
so, I'm just waiting to this.
It'll go.
Because, yeah. You know. I'm waiting patiently. I have Mulin, which has been performing great, and I have some money that is going to become available tomorrow, so I can trade like a different stock. So I'm gonna just see how I'm gonna play everything and just wait and see what runs tomorrow.
I forget what else I own. What else do I own? Excella has been crawling across 50 cents all day.
Jeez, it got killed.
I mean, sold.
It's fine. This is opportunity right here, is what I see. Yeah. Look at that. Look at that floor. Straight up at 499. It's at the 50 cent line on the dot. And then right at the end of the day.
Can I have an Oreo, Dad?
Yes, you can have an Oreo. Right at the end of the day, it dips down and tries to shake out whoever's in their stop loss. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm holding it. I have a bunch of 50 cents.
I'm ready for the squeeze on this one. Like, seriously, take me back to freaking $5. Like, this stock right. is literally, like, undervalued, oversold.
Don't they have, like billions in free cash, or am I stupid?
Yes. This is, like, a cash cow company.
Oh, I have my they have all these turned
contracts.
Off.
This is, like, the next docu. DocuSign.
That's a great one to even keep, like, even when the market's bad, you know?
Cash yeah. Checks. I remember the stock in 2020 was at 30 cents or something, and then it went up to, like, what, $7, $8? So, I mean, the squeeze can definitely happen. It's a good company. The stock just is horrible because they are doing the same thing they're doing with Mulan and SCN and like these hedgies. That's what they're doing to the stock. It's really sad. Yeah. They're creating synthetic shares, fake shares, dark pool shares, whatever you call it.
Yeah. Zen's been on a pretty good uptrend the last 5 days or so.
Yep.
I averaged down at the bottom, luckily, so.
I'm going to hold the stock forever, I think.
What's the ticker?
Sen, S-E-N-N.
Mm.
It used to be Naked.
Oh, C-E-N.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. C-E-N-N. Oh, long day.
Well, it's been an uptrend. Yeah, it looks nice.
Yeah, so. There's I had way down.
Yeah, there's a guy named Rip and Dip, and he does like every day a video on CENN Centro.
I still call it Naked.
Yeah,
Naked.
I'm like, oh, CENN Naked. I'm like, no, that's not what it is anymore.
They're the only other EV stock that has their own chips, like Tesla. So, and they already have like a billion in cash, and they already have their vehicle. I mean, this is a company that is not a SPAC. It actually, or an IPO, it actually was a company, like a real private company, an EV company, and they just decided to use the ticker Naked and do a ticker change and merger.
So, I think it was like PR, right? It's why they chose Daykid, because it was a meme, maybe, or I don't know.
Yeah, they've been around for a while.
Right, yeah, like early 2010s.
Yeah, so they have all kinds of vehicles in China, Japan. They're really big in the Asia market. They have their buses, their mail carriers, all of that is electric.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, guys,
it's not like they have like a cool car, like a sports car, like, you know, like Mulan or anything.
The cars aren't supposed to be sexy. They're just commercial vehicles.
So. Yeah, they're industrial vehicles. Correct.
But guys, I just wanted to come in for a little bit and say hey. But I'm on vacation, so I hope everybody has a good week, and I'll
Thank
try to
you.
Stay as much
Where
as possible.
Yeah,
I'm in Florida. It's called Baton Beach.
Nice.
Or Anna Marie Island.
That's
awesome.
But, well, enjoy the weather. Have a great vacation, and we'll catch you in Discord.
Yeah, thanks for stopping me on your vacation, bro.
No problem. Y'all have a great week. I'll try to stay in touch as much as possible, because I need to play for tomorrow. So you guys have been doing more D&D than I have this week, because I really haven't done much. So I'll stay in touch. Y'all have a good one.
Okay.
Bye.
All right, cool.
Someone give me a chart.
UAVs, I made money on them today. I sold most of my position.
UAVs. What'd they do today?
I bought the, it wasn't quite a double bottom, but I bought below a dollar. Sold today.
I hate this barcode shit.
Yeah, just go to the date.
I just zoom in. Or zoom out, rather.
Yeah, I just go to the daily for this one. It's not very liquid, like.
Yeah. I just like, I don't know, when I look at candles, I see what's happening, and they captivate me. I love time frames on these charts. Time frames are my favorite. Clicking through the frames. Seeing
what caught me was it went above the 50 MA today, so.
Where are my indicators at? What the hell? My 60. It reset all my things. They're all different.
Did you sign in or just not save them? I'm not a Weeble guy, but...
I'm signed in. I don't use Weeble for anything except for the charts, and I only started a couple weeks ago, but I like it. As far as charts go, I don't trade on it. I can't trade on it because I don't have an actual phone number. So, you know. They're like, oh, you don't have a phone? Sorry, you can't trade with us.
Huh.
Okay, thanks. I use a home phone, so appreciate you.
You can use, like, your wife's phone or something? Oh, you just need a mobile number?
She has a Weeble already.
Oh.
I could just, because she opened all the accounts when I did. And then, of course, I'm trading and she's not. But
wow, I wonder how life is without a cell phone.
It's fun.
I couldn't imagine it.
It's fun. Sometimes I, you know, like play video games or whatever. I look up.
Yeah. That's cool though, you know, because I do everything on my phone, trading, real estate.
I do everything here. I do it all here.
Every time I get on my laptop is when I need to write a contract.
I can't wait to have the money to be able to regularly leave my home, but right now, my PC is everything. Literally everything I do is on my PC.
That's okay. You'll get there. I mean, it'll happen sooner.
Yes.
That's what we're working on.
Yep. Yeah, right? I have full, like, I'm not in any way, shape, or form a discouraged kind of person. I'm just real. You know, I don't have a lot of money.
No, I just love it. Yeah.
You know.
I love your attitude. Like, you're just like nonchalant, go with the flow. Like,
yeah, exactly. What am I gonna do? Stress about it? I'm gonna win, is what I'm gonna do.
There you go.
I got time.
And you have a family here that supports you. So
exactly. I love you guys.
How far are you from downtown Chicago?
Like maybe an hour and a half ish.
Oh, okay.
If I probably get there in an hour actually. If I take the freeway.
I lived in Champaign for a while when I was in college.
I might move to Florida at the end of the year.
Wait, what did you say, JC?
I used to live in Champaign.
Champaign, Illinois.
Oh.
Yeah.
Where'd you go to school?
I went to U of I for a little while, and then just like a semester, and then I just joined the Marines. Didn't want to pay for it.
Oh, cool. My brother is a Marine.
Yeah. So that's where I learned how to do my day job now. So
that's cool. Thank you for your service.
Thank you.
See, I learn something new about you guys every day, every time we have these conversations.
A CFVI. I thought about buying back into that one because.
CFVI?
CFVI, yeah.
The Trump stock?
Is that the Rumble one? Not DWAC, but yeah, CFVI.
Yeah, that, yeah.
There's midterms coming up and looks like it's kind of near a bottom.
I like this chart.
I haven't took a position in it. I sold, during the last run. I haven't bought back in yet.
Sorry if you guys are hearing that beeping in the background. That's my fire smoke detector. The thing is so high, I can't reach it. So
I have an 8-year-old on the phone behind me. So,
Yeah, you're good.
I have to wait till Josh gets here this weekend to change out my battery. People are like, you don't own a ladder? I'm like, no. I have a step stool, but it won't really. It's going off again.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, I don't know. Sometimes I get if I click on a chart and I go to the daily, sometimes I have I get no feeling. I'm just like, well, this is a chart. But sometimes when I click on a chart, I'm like, I like that. Just immediately without looking at it, really. I like this one. The MACD.
If you pull up the MACD, yeah, it's crossing like right now as of today.
Oh, yeah. So I like this chart.
Yeah, same. I haven't taken a position in it, but I was gonna look at it tomorrow. See what it does.
Only 30 million float. It's not too low, but it's not too high either.
Well, I figure with the elections coming up later too, maybe it'll do something. Who knows? It's a long way off.
What's LGVN doing?
I don't know, but I got out of that with a little bit of profit, and I'm so grateful.
Yeah, there you go. It's at $6.95. I mean, if you look at the daily, sure.
I can't decide if I'm gonna stay in Sen or not after the April thing. So,
what's happening in April? Good lord!
Isn't that their first financials or quarterly?
Oh yeah, as a new company.
Yeah, everyone's really looking forward to that, so I don't know if it's just hype or wishful thinking, so.
Well, remember, when they took over the company, they were talking about, the company talked about, like, their financials a little bit and where they were.
Right.
So we have to see what happens.
Yeah.
I just want the stock to go to, like, where are these apes at, you know? Like, let's go.
Right, that's what I was thinking. And the memes
are squeezed. I know.
I'm so pessimistic. Can I see
GME today? GME went through the roof today. It went from $94 to like what? What did it end up at? Like a
$123.
You know what's funny though? Look. You know what's funny about stocks like GME in particular is
the volume.
I played GME for like a full year. I always just had some, and I sold it when it was green and bought it when it was red. You know what I'm saying? But it's always gonna go from 90 to 120 something. It's always what it does. It's crazy. If you just watch GME, you can catch that move every time because it is a fucking meme. Because GameStop, I'm a gamer. That's my whole life. GameStop sucks.
Right.
The fact that that store is valued at $125 is ridiculous. It's a total meme.
Yeah.
I don't buy anything from GameStop.
Same thing.
It's just a fucking theater.
Are they really just expensive? Like, I don't know about
GameStop. No, they just suck. Their customer service sucks. if you buy a game there, it costs you $65, $75, because that's what they cost. And then when you sell it back, they give you $15, $5. It's crazy.
Yeah.
You
know what I mean? It's just I've gotten $250.
They're terrible. I spent my whole childhood saving money to buy games for a whole year, and then I go sell that whole year's worth of games to get one new game. And they didn't give a shit. They're like, sure, kid, I'll take all your shit. You know what I mean? They're just terrible. Yeah, I've worked there, and they're terrible.
Now you just buy digital. I haven't gone to GameStop in years.
I buy either on Amazon or digital. GameStop sucks. They sell collectibles, and that's it, which I also buy on Amazon. why they call it a meme stock. Wish is a meme stock because Wish fucking sucks. Have you ever bought something off of Wish? It's cheap Chinese crap. It's really terrible. Everything is a knockoff of everything, and that's why it's $5 for something that should be $90 because it's fake. So the fact that Wish is like ever a hot stock is such a meme. The company's trash. It's trash. Not like they have good products. They literally just make fake shit and sell it to you with pictures of the real shit on their page. And everybody's like, what a great stock. Because it's a meme. So if you watch the memes, memes are the only stocks that you should watch Twitter for. If Twitter's like, fucking GME, then you might get an idea that you should hop in it because that's what fuels it, because it's a meme.
It's hilarious. DSS has been like just going up too. I've just been watching that thing for like all of March.
Okay, look at GME. So what do you guys think this is going to do tomorrow? You think it's going to just keep going? Because that's what all the apes think. You think it's just going to keep fucking going? Of course it's not going to keep going. Look, let's just do basic charting here. There's your level. There you go. It's not going to keep going. If it does, it's going to sell. It's going to sell off. Let's look at the Bollinger Bands on the one day. So on the one day, it's still within the bands. But let's go to just one chart lower. The fucking 4 hour, this isn't staying up here. It might get a push, but it's not staying up here. That's crazy. Look, it went to 143 after hours. It's going to sell off big time pre-market.
Probably.
In my opinion.
Okay, can you do my chart, SCYRN? You're really good at this.
SCYRN or CYRN?
CYRN.
Oh, yeah, daily. Get rid of the Bollinger Bands and shit, all the marks I got.
What I like about this is it's above all the MAs except the 200. The 200's at 919.
Yeah. So look at this. Look at this level. I mean, if you just look right here, that's right at the 200. That's where this candle goes.
Right.
The wicks only break above it. You never see any candle body above it except for this crazy day, which sold off quickly. It opened the next day under that. So that, you know. So, but today, you know, it's not like it was pushing it today. I mean, it was, but not the candle body. If it breaks it, it could go a little bit. This isn't a meme, you know what I mean? Like, this is a stock that isn't fucking GameStop.
Yeah, this is a stock that's getting a lot of hype, though.
Right. So, yep. I mean, it's definitely going to get sell-off because just like every stock that gets hype, it gets sell-off, at least from what I see. If it's hyped up, it sells off big time that day. You know what I mean? In some way, or the next morning or something. But
I wanted to swing it, but I just watch it.
It's getting hyped up for good reason. There's a war going on with Russia, and they're hacking our computers. You know what I mean? So it's like, you know, it's not a meme stock. So I think just for that reason alone, it could break, you know, what you would normally, because I'm super pessimistic. If I look at this and I'm like, oh, it's hitting this level, there's no fucking way it's breaking it, even though it might. I just want to lose money. So I'm not going to buy in when it's right here, because then it'll go straight down. I wait till it's going to confirm. I need like a candle or two, you know, and then I'll buy it.
Right there. Yeah.
But I'm not going to buy this candle as it's breaking here so I can get in as early as possible because I'm going to lose money, clearly. But I do think that if you're swinging this, you know, this is a clearly a stock that has good reason to be going up. It's obviously volatile and it's pumped like crazy, but it's, you know.
Mm-hmm. It's a low float.
I don't give a shit about fundamentals either, and I know that they're important, but I just, like, can't get myself to look up fucking form 3s and form 4s and form 6ks and form 8ks and 10k. I can't get myself to do it. And when I do it, I look through it, and I'm like, oh, I don't give a fuck, and I go look at the chart, and the chart looks great, and I buy it, and I make money. You know what I mean? And I'm like,
Did I tell you guys about my lotto stock?
Hear it. I love lottos.
G. Oh my god, guys, the float on this is like 1 million.
ALLG.
And today they filed an 8K to confirm that their float is only 1 point some million. So literally the stock has been my money maker for like the last I think a week now. You have to get in at like around $8 and that shit will run to 11 and that's when you take your profits. But like now that they have confirmed the float, you might see this run like ISPO.
I like to look at charts on the 15-minute like this.
Hey, what's the indicator called for like when like PENN? It always goes like $3 or $4 every day. It moves.
Wait, for what?
I forgot what it's called, but it measures like, you know, every day the stock goes like 50 cents every day, you know, up or down, like PENN. That's why I love trading it, because it goes up like $3 to $5 every day.
It's just fluctuating. You're looking for an indicator?
I forgot what the name of it is. There's something, yeah.
And on the chart, PENN is where you use it?
So PENN's just my example, just for like, Char's saying it always moves up from 8 to 11. Like I know PENN, how PENN trades, like the back of my hand. If you look at every day on the daily chart, it goes up $3 to $4, whether it's red or green. It's on a huge downtrend right now, but every day it moves. So whether you're shorting it or, you know, going long on it, it moves at least a couple bucks.
Bottom right here, $40.
Yep. Every time. But I forget how much.
Look at that. You see, that's why I love levels. Because you look at this right here, all I see is one example of $40. But I said bottom here for $40. And then you just zoom out, scroll to the left, and look how perfect that is. Look at that. $40 is the level. That's a very key level there. And I don't know if it'll ever get there again, but if it ever does. You know what I mean? Like, I can look at this chart and know that 40 is a key level, and I'll set an alert. I'll set an alert right here for, like, 40, 50. And maybe one day when I'm trading, it pops up and says, hey, just so you know, this stock's down here. And then I might shift my attention towards PENN because I know, hey, this is the bottom, at least a key level.
What's PENN at right now?
44.05. After hours, closed at
43.98.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're at a double bottom.
Yeah, those stocks where you like Lucid is another one. It always goes from like 22 to 25. Today did actually a little better. So you know those types of stocks, you should know exactly when to buy them because you know it's going to go up. Like it's like reached its new bottom.
Yeah, the ceiling becomes the floor. What did I do? I showed an example. This is a good one. I showed an example to Lori the other day. I'm in Archon here. I'll go to the 5 minute. All these lines are crazy because I like to watch this one on the 5 minute as I'm trading it. But this is the best way for me to look at support and resistance. As if. Look at it like it's a skyscraper and the stock is climbing the elevator, the escalators or whatever. This is the ceiling and this is the floor. And when it goes up the stairs, the ceiling becomes the floor. You know what I mean? And there you go. So when you look at support and resistance levels, anything can be a new floor. It doesn't have to be the bottom to be the floor. That's my point. You know what I mean? You just got to identify the current floor that the stock is on and guess if it wants to go downstairs or upstairs. Based on what it's done prior. Yuna? Hello? Am I,
Sorry, I'm here.
I'm sorry, I have like the Thundercats playing behind me. I got distracted. I'll stop talking. And then no one else filled in the blanks.
What's up? Hey, can we look at BBI? That's been moving.
BBI. Again, sorry about the Thundercats. Ooh, they had a nice move today. So what, whenever I see something have a move like this on the daily, I like to go to the daily and like just draw a horizontal line where the body ended and go and see if that's a level of some kind. You know, and see if it can break it. See if it's over a level. Like, I think this would be a better level because more things fuck with that line. You know what I'm saying? So it looks like it broke the level. So the question is, where will it open tomorrow morning? This level is 2.8, and the after hours it's gone down to 29 cents. So it could open right here and keep going. That's my opinion. I don't know anything, though. And then fucking... there's your floor, 19 cents. So if you were to buy this stock tomorrow at 29 cents, you're risking, in my opinion, 10 cents on the share because it's going to drop to a potential bottom of 19 or 20 cents, rather. So 9 cents on the shares is what you'd be risking. IMO. So if you buy 500 shares, you know what I mean? You could just guesstimate how much money you can lose versus where you think it could go. So you look at this past run. And put like a horizontal line right here. And that might not be a level, but I think it is because you see these candles obey it a little bit. So the question is, do you think this will keep running up to 39 cents? Because you stand to make a little more profit if it gets all the way up here than you stand to lose. But is this big gap, are you willing to risk that much to get this in exchange? If it's a small, like let's say your level's down here and this is where you're buying. And this is your gap up that you think could be filled. That's low risk, high profit. You know what I'm saying? But I think this is a level on this thing. And I think if it opens and wants to stay up here, if it doesn't want to go back downstairs really quick, then it'll start walking on this floor. And 27, 28 might be a good spot to buy. I'll alert it. I'm going to set an alert. See if it gets to it.
And that's the daily, right? You're looking at the daily?
Yeah.
Is that right? Okay.
Yeah, I'm on the daily. So yeah, it's not like we're gonna wake up in the morning and see a bunch of candles on this chart.
Right.
And that's another thing. It's not like super volatile in that sense. Like this didn't happen today. This was the day. So let's see what happened actually during the day with the stock. If you look at it, it looks like it walked up the 9 EMA. This is the 20 that I have on there. Yeah, up the 20 as a support. When it dips under 20 EMA, it gets bought. But it walked up the 9. You know, like, it doesn't look like it made any crazy move up. It didn't have any major sell-off or anything. It's a penny stock.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's possible for it to keep on with this climb. I mean, also, look at it. Look at this chart like this. So we're looking at it from up close, and I'm comparing it to these past candles, going, I don't know, you know, it might stop when it gets here. It might not make it up there. But if you zoom out and look at this chart, this is the bottom, you know? Like, it's had a little spike here. You could probably wait and buy it on its dip tomorrow, which I think will happen because I'm pessimistic as hell. And anytime you see a huge green candle like this, the next one's going to be fucking red. So wait until it's down at the bottom tomorrow afternoon, in my opinion, and then buy some. And you could probably swing it for a nice little swing. I don't know anything about the company. So it might be trash completely, which they all are, but, you know, you could probably swing it up to, it has a gap to fill. Gaps always get filled.
Right.
Eventually. So right here, we got 50 cents. Hold on. I hit all my drawings. 50 cents right here. It can make it up to, it's got to fill that gap. So if you're looking for a potential bottom buy, it might bounce off one of the EMAs. Like, maybe it drops down and bounces off the 200, and you could buy it for 25 cents at its low tomorrow.
Are you still in the inning?
No, but I watch it every day. Yeah. I should have been in it. I saw it drop to 188 yesterday, and I wanted in and didn't pull the trigger, and I'm stupid because it's 2-something today. I would have sold it because I'm pessimistic as hell. I would have been like, 12 cents? Let's go. I'm taking that fucking profit. I'm cheap. Penny flipper. Let's do it. Yeah, it's 201 right now. That's actually not. It was 20. I think it got. Where did it get to earlier today? 205, yeah. Yeah. Also, I use my my TradingView chart for any. Because that's like the chart that I've taken the most care of. And it tells me a lot. It's very clean. This is just the Weeble chart for any, but I have like a load zone for any down here. And right here, this line actually happens to be the bottom of that load zone, and it stops like right here, I think. So this is still in the load zone for any, as far as I'm concerned.
220
is the level.
225 looks like it's where it's headed, at least.
Yeah. 222 right here, if I can find it. 222. That is a level. Oh, yeah, look, it's right there. That's a level. That's my box. This is my load zone. At 222 is over here is when the big uptrend started. See? So it came up here, it dipped down, and then bam, it had a big uptrend. So 222 on my past chart was that key start level, and then it dipped all the way back down to 222, and ever since then, this has been considered my buy zone because it's under 222. And when it dipped under this, it was on March 15th, 14th, when everything was fucked up. Everything was way under its like usual levels on that day. I didn't see it or I would have bought it, but yeah. This is still my load zone as far as I'm concerned. But also $2 is a level that it has to hold. You know what I mean? Anytime it's a like on the dollar, it's always a level, in my opinion, for every stock. Anytime something goes up, if it hits 45, 46, 47, those are all like key little points. They might not be strong levels, but they're points that trigger people's brain. Like, oh, it's 47. Should I sell? 48. What are we doing? You know, it's like you have to think about how people think. Think about how you think about your stocks while you're trading, and try to think about how people think about their stocks while they're trading. Anybody who has this, how would they play it? If they were in down here, how are they going to play it right now? In my opinion, I think that's the key. And don't take my word for it, because I'm not successful yet. But in my opinion, that's the key, is to get into the minds of all the traders. If you can think from the point of view of all of the possible types of trader, you can get a better picture of where any given stock might go, who might be trading it, when they might sell it, when they might buy it. It's all psychology. It's all the stock market is. Numbers on a screen and the human mind. You know, lines. Every indicator, I don't care what it is, every indicator is just trying to tell you, unless it's something down here, which it's still just trying to tell you the same thing. Any indicator that drops a line on this chart is just trying to tell you a support or a resistance. It doesn't matter what it is. The Bollinger Bands. What do? It's a support and a resistance. Look at it. They drop under it, they go back up. They go over it, they go down. They hit the middle, who knows, maybe, who knows? It's possible. You know, like, every indicator is so easy to use if you just look at it as a support and resistance. And the only reason they're all different is because some traders like to use this one, some traders like to use that one. But they all tell you the same fucking thing. What's the floor? What's the ceiling? Where is it going to go? Maybe. Trading's easy. It's just we make it complex because there's so many ways to do it. And you think, how do I do it? There's so many ways. Which one is my way? It's not like doing something where there's one way to write your name. You know what I mean? Like, there's a few ways, but they're all the same. You're just writing your damn name down. When it comes to the stock market, there's so many ways to do it. But it's easy. It's you buy red, you sell green. You use lines on a chart to find out what's red and what's green.
To say the last 2 weeks, I've been in a lot of fundamental plays, come up, oh my god, I can't even say it. Commodities. What's wrong with me? Sorry guys, I am like, I need to get some sleep. You know, playing the trends, agricultural stocks, to what's going on with SPY, to, you know, the cybersecurity stuff. I've been really focusing on a lot of fundamental plays because I feel like it's taken me back to my 2020 trading when it was all COVID and BioStock plays. So what's helped me a lot is like the technicals that I'm learning from the charting, but also incorporating my fundamentals. So just taking a little time to see why the stock is running. Like there's a lot of traders like Bentley Trading and even Inbar, they don't really pay attention to the stock that they're trading. They're just trading because, hey, the chart looks bullish. They got a signal and it's about to run. So they're in and out, right? But if you take just a little bit of time to wonder why this stock is having more than an unusual volume per day, and it's got news. So what is the news? Like, you know, let me go look at the news real quick. Like NRSN, that had a very big news. It's got an FDA destination for I forgot what the drug was, but anyway, it was a medical breakthrough for that company. The stock went from $2 to $8. I knew that's what it was going to do because I'm used to playing bios. When you have bio stocks like that, those are the ones that you want to be in early because you know it's going to give you a $4 to $5 spread. So with those types of stocks, yes, it did have a multiple. It had breakthroughs. It had a bunch of fake outs. It had all of these things. But if you saw the volume coming in from $2 to $8 yesterday, oh, my God, I made a lot of money on that stock. So yes, technicals is the number one key thing. But if you just take a little bit of time to find out why the stock is running, and you understand the news and you understand like, well, this is kind of major, you know?
Yeah, like you don't have to be like, who was it? Pablo. You don't have to be the person that digs through all the filings in order to use the fundamentals to your advantage. If you're a technical trader, you can look at the news and get like a common sense, you know, like,
yeah,
Russia's hacking us. Like, okay, CERN, maybe, you know what I mean? That's the fundamental research. Then you go look at the chart.
Right. And then you see it's being bullish and you see the volume pouring in and you see all of these things happening. So don't take your profits, but don't try not to penny pinch your profits, you know, because you can make a lot more money if you just hold it for like five more minutes.
But be careful. Because you could lose all your money if you just hold it for five more minutes to play the other side, to play
that is true.
Advocate, you know,
that's why you got to know your key levels. And then you also got to know like what you're in.
You have to have conviction in your play before you don't. If you think, I don't know if I should sell this, I don't know, like sell it. But if you're like, oh, I don't want to sell this because I think it's going here because of this reason, then you're clearly, you have conviction and you have a reason to hold that play. If you don't have a reason to hold the play,
it's gotta be a really good reason though. Right, like it's gotta be like a medical breakthrough or something where it's like, you know, the institutional buyers are going to come in and
it's gonna
buy
have
the
a couple
stock.
More days or maybe a week or two. I mean, like if you bought the stock with the purpose of making money because you like the chart, and now the chart is showing the stock is green, you should sell it.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
That's how I feel. Because you don't know why you're in it other than you wanted it to go green. And now it is. So you should sell it. You know what I mean?
Like that one stock today, the drone stock, Dragonfly. Like,
oh, I watched that all day.
I missed that call today. And I was kind of upset because I was like, wow, that's a huge call because they're actually going to be sent.
What's the
their
ticker?
Drones are going to be sent to Ukraine. DPRO.
Lori would know. She was telling me all day.
Yeah. So that stock, right?
DPRO.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. The Inbar alerted it and I missed it by like 10 minutes, guys. I was so pissed.
Oh, well, look. Look at it. Look at it.
67.
Look what happened to it, though. This is today, okay?
Well, yeah, you don't hold it that long.
He ordered it at 267, which is, oh, if you look at here, it's a level I've got mapped out already. He alerted it right here in the pre-market, and that is at 7:25, so that's 25 minutes into your trading day, right? You missed it, and it went up.
But I got back in. I got in on the dip.
There you go. The dip in the pre-market here or here?
I got in at 290-something right before the market opened.
Yes.
And
then so like right here.
$3. Yep.
And
I sold it.
It hit 384. So then Lori and I saw it. She mentioned that you were in it. And I'm like, all right, let's pull this chart up. So we did. And we're considering maybe we should get in because it's on this uptrend. And this was the candle that I said, if I was going to buy it, it might be right here. And then it went up. But look at it. Then all day, it shot right back down. Yep. It consolidated. And boom, we get sell-off. It finds a new level back here where we charted earlier. It finds a new level and look at it all day. Now it's down 226. And you
don't, that's a play that you don't get back in.
Right. So let's say you're holding this play and you're like, well, Shar said if I hold it for just 5 more minutes, I can make a lot more money. And this is the 5 minutes that you chose that you might be able to hold it. Then you didn't listen to Shar properly, because what she said is hold it for 5 more minutes has got to be a real good fucking reason. If you're in a stock like this and it's at these levels and it's 5 minutes into the trading day, get the fuck out.
Mm-hmm.
Get out. Yeah. And don't look back.
I was hoping that would go, but it didn't. It didn't. It got shorted.
Yeah.
So that's a play that, you know, you get in, you get out, you get in, and you get out. That was it.
These are 5 minute candles. So this sell off right here from 311 to 277, you might have got up to go take a poop and lost all your money.
I didn't,
you know what I'm saying?
After I took my profits in the morning, I didn't even look at it. And then I went and looked and I was like, what the hell? Why is it at $2? I was like, what happened to it?
And this is why you have to be very careful, especially if you have a job. If you're out working and you're trying to trade, I wouldn't trade any stock like this. If you're not sitting in front of your computer or full attention on your phone or whatever it is you trade with, I wouldn't get into any stock like this. I would only swing stuff with that kind of life. Because this is, I don't know. I started trading in the Fin Twitter verse. I've seen so many people chase crap and lose everything.
I like buying stocks when they're red and like down. IMPP.
Buy them when no one wants them.
Yesterday was down to like a dollar. I don't know what happened in pre-market yesterday with IMPP, but it was down like 48%. And I was like, what the hell happened? And I saw it at $1.27. And I'm like, yep, I'm about to buy it. And then look, it just shot up. This was yesterday.
5 minute of right there.
Yeah.
When did you buy it?
In pre-market, like right in the market open, like 7 o'clock in the morning. So 6 o'clock your time.
So let's see. This is New York time. So right here.
This was yesterday. Yeah.
This is yesterday, right? 3:21. Yeah. So right here for $1.20 something.
Mm-hmm.
So you made 40-50 cents on the share.
No, it went all the way up to what? $3.
Yesterday?
Yeah, hold on. Let me look at my order. It went up to $2. Yeah, almost $3. Hold on.
Why doesn't this chart show that?
Pre-market. Hold on. Orders. Let me see. Hold on 1 second. I got to scroll. I did a lot of trades.
It's 9 o'clock.
Oh, shit. Sorry.
10 o'clock for you.
No, okay, I bought it at $1.27.
Yeah.
And right, I sold it. Where did I sell it? Hold on. Why doesn't it show me when I closed it? Sorry. I don't know where it is. Hold on.
The chart says in the post market it got to 169 because that's always a key level because 69. And then everybody sold it. That's according to the chart, but you know, charts.
This is so weird. I can't find my freaking cell. No. What was yesterday? The 20th, right? The 21st. Okay. I have so many trades. I'm scrolling. What was the high in pre-market?
The high in pre-market on the 21st?
Yes.
Was... Well, it was... Oh, no. Okay, let's see.
Bye.
The pre-market started right... As soon as it started, it was at the high of 215, and then it sold off massively.
Sorry. I'm sorry. I sold it at $1.80.
So you must have caught, like... Because so that, the, I see all the time stocks dip to numbers that don't show up on the chart.
So yeah, I sold it at $1.80. So it went from $1.27 to like $2 pre-market.
Yeah, that's not a bad trade. Especially it's not even like it's a day trade, but it's not a, you know, it's not a stressful day trade.
And Enbar called it. He was like, it's gonna shoot up. And I'm like, okay. And it was down 40-some%.
I need like some sort of earpiece. So whenever Inbar says something, I just hear it automatically. I'm going to invent that. Eventually I'll pay him.
All right.
I swear to God, he's from the fucking future. I swear a lot, sorry.
All right, well, it's 10 o'clock. I think we should call it a night because I'm so sad. I'm so sleepy.
Yeah, it's late. It is.
Thank you guys for joining. I guess we'll end it. Do you guys have anything to say? Anyone?
Love you guys.
Love you guys. Thanks for joining.
Good night. Thank you.
Thank
Good
you.
Night. Thanks, guys.
Good night.
Playing this video if anybody wants to watch it. I want to watch it.
I did not have a rich father. Not from, well-educated. I said I tried 3 times for university. All failed. For the last time, I went to the teacher's college, which was considered the 3rd or 4th class of my city. But I think that is the best university I've ever had. Better than Harvard and Wharton. I applied for Harvard for 10 times. All failed, they don't even want to see me, you know, terrible. And I think that is a normal life. It was so difficult at that time. I was so frustrated because I taught in the university. My pay was $10 a month. It was not easy, but I believe that something is waiting for me there. And I have to work hard to prove myself. That was the tough experience. And I never thought I was smart. Nobody believed that I could be successful because everybody said, well, this guy think differently, think crazily. You know, they think about something never worked. Nobody agreed with it. As I said, I believe it because I saw the computer in 1994 when I went to the USA. I think this thing could be big. I never thought it would be that big like today. Honestly, people say you're smart, you have a big vision. I'm lucky to know a lot of famous people. Bill Gates, Warren Buffett, Jack Welch, Larry Page, Mark Zuckerberg. I would have liked to share with you the difference between those people and other people. They are always optimistic for the future. They never complain. They always try to solve the problems of the others. And I think where is the opportunity? The opportunity always lies in the place where people complain. Some people sit there complain. You think, if I can solve that complaint, that's the opportunity. Because when everybody agrees, why this opportunity should be yours? Because a lot of people don't agree with it. And you think this is good. Think carefully and find a group of people working together. And making sure the people working with you together believe the dreams. Whether investors believe in this or not, whether your friends believe it or not, whether your parents believe it or not, that's not important. You believe it, your team believe it, and work day and night on this. That's how the things happen. Everybody is the same, because we are stuck from the same line. The best assets you have is that you are young. Don't complain. Let the other people complain. Those people complain, those people who still. Think about how you can make things different. Use your own brain to think. Is that an opportunity inside? Is there anything I can do that make the difference? Think about this. And then when you think about this, start to do it. I saw a lot of people, young people, have fantastic ideas every evening. But in the morning, they go to the office same again. Make the move. Make the action. To everybody, to any person, tomorrow is new. But you have to work very hard, right? Either work for the others or work for yourself. And I choose the way, work for myself. But working for myself, that means working for the society. If you really want to work for yourself, think about the others, making sure you help others. Because only when the other people are successful, when the other people are happy, you'll be successful, you will be happy.
Good night, everybody. All rights reserved.